And you're gonna repeat this over and over and over again. And you're gonna repeat this over and over and over again. How you doing? Welcome to Van's Drumming Extreme Drum Set Techniques. My name's Randy Van Patten.
Hey everybody, this is Eric Rosbrock from DrummerConnection.com, and I'm out here today with a box of cheese puffs, Randy Van Patten, and Jeff Lutz. And today we are going to start the production of your brand new DVD.
Yeah, this weekend. Kicking it off. Shooting some stuff today, and tomorrow the big show. Craziness, it's wild.
Awesome. So you've already produced one DVD, VanzDrumming has.
Yep.
And it's been out for at least two, 3 years.
Three years.
Okay.
Yeah.
You guys have had good success off of that, so you're doing another one.
Yeah, yeah. This one is a little bit different. Jeff, funny story, is he used to be my teacher when I was like a little youngin', 82 or something, we said.
Yep.
So yeah, so when I was a kid, he's the one that taught me all my cool grooves and
sweet.
And then so forth. So we connected and said, hey, it'd be neat to do something together. Jeff's like, all right, I'll fly down. So he did, and here we are. So that's pretty awesome.
So that's kind of cool. You get to reunite with somebody who actually paved the way for you to get into drumming.
Ooh, if you want to put it out there, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, that sounds great.
Cool. Well, Jeff, it is absolutely a pleasure to meet you. Randy, I've met you before, so
yeah.
It's good to see you again. And the one thing I like to point out is you've had a great success on your YouTube channel.
Yeah.
And now, I know from a fact that as somebody who's starting out a YouTube channel, to get yourself noticed on YouTube, that's a pretty big thing. You have to kind of have something that they're really looking for. So throughout your trial and error with YouTube, I know you've had trial and error.
Yeah, yeah.
What are some of the things that helped you really kind of kick off and get your name out there?
I think just a matter of having fun with it. There's too many teachers, and this is why my DVD did well, I think, is too. There's so many teachers out there, they're just, you know, they have some great content, and they're awesome drummers, but they're either just extremely boring to watch, or they're just playing way over top of your head, maybe, and you know, for the guys who are, a lot of the YouTube people I think watching are probably people who are younger, drummers just starting out, or, is that our fly again? We have a fly.
Yeah, we have a fly. Yeah.
And so, I just think just having fun. I think people enjoy the fact that I can goof around, I can screw up, and I leave it. I think that makes people realize that I'm not like, you know, I'm just a regular guy, like everybody else,
yeah.
You know? If I mess up something, I'm like, all right, well, there you go. I messed it up. So what, you know? So it's kind of cool. But I think that's what makes it fun, is just goofing around and having fun. You know, if you're not having fun, then why do it?
Do you have any YouTube experience there, Jeff?
No. I'm just getting up on Facebook this week. So
cool.
It's just taking a little time, but I'm getting into the 21st century.
Awesome. Well, this just goes to show you that no matter where you are, you can still play drums and have fun.
That's right.
So,
Jeff's backing is obviously, he's a big session guy and jazz and touring around the northern states, right?
You're too kind.
Well, I've heard some of the samples that you guys were recording earlier, and they sound wonderful. I'm serious. I mean, the sound that you guys have out of this room and you know, the way the kits are mic'd up and recorded, this is definitely
We've been having a ball here all day long. We've been playing tracks, some of your guys' tracks. He's been playing a few, I've been playing a few. We've been just having fun.
Very cool. That's all about us, without having fun playing drums.
That's
if
right.
You're not having fun, you should be doing something
that's,
else.
That's part of the DVD.
And eating
awesome.
Cheese balls.
Cool, yeah. And by the way, got any rudiments you want to show me on those cheese balls?
Oh, yeah. So this is a paradiddle, everyone. We'll go with that. That's not too bad. That's not too bad. Got a nice rim shot, too.
Mic that
we
up.
We might have to do a lesson on the cheese balls. It's a shaker.
Yeah.
So we got, hey, what do these cost? $5.99 at Costco?
I don't know.
Something like that?
They just
cheese
came
balls.
Home.
Check them out on Van's Drumming. You can buy your cheese ball shaker.
Yeah, but they're going to have a nice logo on them.
And we don't promise that the cheese balls will come to you in any edible fashion. So, you know, but,
how processed are those already?
So let's go back to where you came from as far as drumming.
You okay?
You've been playing for a while. I've seen some of your older pictures, you know, the big hairband days and everything. You've
had
big Lubig cans, and you know, you played on all kinds of different drums and throughout the years. What has been your drive throughout this whole passion pursuit of drumming that has just kind of, besides dropping your sticks?
Thank you.
What has been your drive? What is it that brings you back to it every single time?
Jeez. That's it. It's passion. Having fun. I just do it because I enjoy it. I you know, obviously playing and gigging is great. Getting on stage in front of people is awesome. But for me, the teaching and all the YouTube stuff and this DVD stuff, it's just the coolest satisfaction to know that you're helping somebody or these young drummers, and you know they're educating somebody
around
that,
the world.
Well, it's just awesome to know that I'm helping people out. I get satisfaction from that. You know, whether I'm teaching a lesson here and knowing that the person walks away with, hey man, you know, I walked out of here with something, or you read some comments on YouTube like, oh man, I can't believe I didn't think of that, or it's a cool thing. So just,
yeah,
you know, I enjoy playing, and it's just, you know, I have fun doing it, and you know, it's my outlet for
so
wackiness.
Things, you know, we're talking about YouTube, talking about online drumming, talking about sharing our information out there as rapidly and fast as possible and reaching the entire world. When we do that, we tend to get some negative feedback. Everybody's going to get negative feedback, and no matter what you do, there's always going to be, as we call, haters or, you know, mm-hmm. negative people out there. So I'm sure, you know, going through your YouTube phase and into releasing your DVDs, you've had bad comments and bad reviews. I mean, what is it that when you see those, how do they sit with you? What kind of tips can you give to people out there who are just venturing into uploading that?
Well, you know your level of playing. I mean, you know where you're at, and you know, of course, everybody's gonna be like, oh, well, so and so does this better, I can do that. This is the point of, hey, here's where I am. If they're putting something on YouTube, I'm putting a lesson up. This is where I am at. This is what I have to offer, and maybe John Bonham wouldn't have played it this way, and maybe his bass drum came before his time. You know, whatever it is, it is what it is. This is my interpretation. That's what I usually will disclaim first and say, this may be not, you know, this may not be right. I've been stuff up there where I actually screwed up the timing of something, and like I was actually reading it off a certain way, and everyone's like, ooh, that's landing on the and of two, and this, that, and the other. I'm like, all right, guys, whatever. I had fun with it. And
it's kind of fascinating to know that other people can speak that language, but at the same point, calling you out on it and how they go about it is, you know,
yeah.
It's all constructive criticism is what the best thing to look for is. So, your DVD that we're shooting today, or tomorrow, this weekend, when is it going to be able to hit the market, and when can people get it?
I'm hoping October. You know, 3 years ago it was October 31st. I released the first one. I'm hoping to get this one out the door early October. I'm hoping so.
Okay.
You know, we can get all of our ducks in a row and get it done. Obviously, just a lot of editing to be involved.
Yeah,
okay. And we're gonna have so much content. We might have two DVDs. I don't know. We'll see. We'll see where it goes. But
here we come.
Oh, the series.
Yeah.
Very cool. Each one's only 5 minutes long, but you know.
Yeah. Just a couple of things. What are you going to be covering specifically in this DVD that would be different from your other one?
The other one obviously was a lot of like grooves and little patterns and fun little nuggets of information. This one is really focusing on trying to get drummers to pay more attention to locking in with the rest of the band, getting in the pocket. The title of this one's called In the Pocket. And just, you know, it's something like I think we were talking about earlier, Jeff, is that you can't explain. You can't really tell somebody.
Yeah.
That's what we're challenged with on this DVD is trying to get people to understand what In the Pocket means.
That's tough.
Because it's really more of a feeling you get.
Yeah.
And it's how the whole band gels and locks together. So we're hoping to bring some techniques to the table that'll help drummers like with different styles of music listening for different things and or different patterns, you know. What's cool is that I'm obviously more of like a rock drummer. That's pretty much my background. With Jeff coming in with some more, you know, funk and Latin and jazz stuff, we both of us have totally different styles, so it's really cool to see us how well it's going to gel. Until tomorrow, when tomorrow's over, we're either going to say, that was absolutely amazing and it really worked out well, which I'm sure it will, and we'll be able to provide something to people which is going to have just a big, well-rounded, you know, product. Whereas if it was me in here, I'd be like, yeah, I can attempt a swing beat, but it's going to sound like an attempted swing beat, you know what I mean?
And that's what I respect about this project is you brought in, you know, Jeff over here, and he's probably got a completely different feel than you do on everything.
Oh,
you play.
We're two different drummers, for sure.
And that's what's going to be really cool to see in this approach on this DVD is just a dual approach at it. You know, so that's really awesome. And so we're shooting for October.
Yeah, I mean, if it comes out earlier, you know, of course we'll get it out.
And we'll keep you updated on DC. And also, you know, keep an eye on VanzDrumming.com. And we'll post some links up on this video. And make sure you check out Randy on YouTube. Jeff Lutz, Randy Van Patten from VanzDrumming out here on the brand new DVD shoot coming up. And we're going to try to get a drum kit tour.
Drum kit tour?
Yeah.
You can do it.
Awesome. Well, thanks a lot for your time. And
awesome.
We're going to show you the gear. And stay tuned. And we'll keep you updated on the progress of this DVD.
Thank you, sir. Appreciate it.
We didn't really do anything funny in that.
No, we talk about cheese balls.
Cheese balls.
In the air for a second. Hey, this is Randy Van Patten here, Van's Drumming. Check it out. I'm here to give you a quick little tour of my rig, the Beast drum kit. Yamaha Maple Custom Absolutes. I have one more drum that's over there, but that's all right. Basically, I've got a running an 8-8, one's deeper than the other. And then I got a 10-12, 14-16. Obviously, it's again Maple Custom, using the Evans EC2 coated SSTs on the toms, brand new. And look at that, we already got a dent on one. Can you believe that? So I got a G2 on my snare, which is a 6.5-inch maple pearl snare. Actually, rebuilt pearl snare that with new hardware and such. I'm running. Right now, I have Iron Cobras on here. I also have some DWs, but right now I'm playing the Iron Cobras. And obviously, it's a Gibraltar rack, all Yamaha hardware for the most part. Symbol wise, I've got a nice little Zildjian A China. I've got a medium 20 inch Zildjian Ride. A couple Fat Boy splashes just for fun of it. A custom 18 inch Rock Crash. A Z custom Rock Crash 17 inch. And then a 14 inch A custom regular little Crash. And then these are new beat hi-hat 14 inches. They're old, but they sound awesome, so I kind of like to play them. Microphones, I'm just running the PG56s on the toms and the snare, and I think these things are
SM81?
Yeah, 81s. And they actually sound really nice. I have an EV kick drum, which I forgot which one I'm using, but it's awesome. So it's a the ND868, so this thing's a beast. Obviously, if you have crappy drum mics or even just 57s on the whole kit, at least spend the money on a nice kick mic, because that's going to make or break your kit.
Love these.
And I have an LP cowbell. Look at that. Listen to it, too. Dude, the net like makes a set. So
that sounds sweet.
Other than that, you know, there's not much else to it. That's the kit, the rig, the Beast.
Okay, I got a question for you. Why do you use 2 8-inch toms? What's the
Why do I use 2 8-inch toms? Because I like more toms, and Yamaha doesn't come out with a 6
okay.
for this particular style. And... one is deeper than the other. One is a little bit, one's I think an 8x8, and one's probably an 8x10 or something of that nature.
Awesome.
And I have another 14 inch floor that lives over here. It's just not here right now.
You usually keep them right here?
It's right here.
Nice.
So,
You definitely like a lot of toms. That's pretty cool.
I like toms.
Yeah. All right. Well, this has been Randy Van Patten.
Oh, and I have a Rocket Sock drum tone.
Oh, yeah. We can't leave that out.
Oh, it's amazing.
You got the saddle one too, yeah.
And it has hydraulics. It goes up and down.
Yes.
You want me to show you?
Sure.
It's very exciting.
Demonstrate the...
Watch this, guys. If you don't have one, watch this. Ready? Up. And down. Nice. I mean, that's... doesn't get any better than that.
Cool.
Well, thanks,
Randy, for your time.
Thank you.
Check out VanzDrumming.com for more information and see this kit in action.
And thanks to Drummer Connection for bringing us all this cool video.
Sweet.
Content and have awesome stuff.
One.
Repeat this over and over and over again. And you're going to repeat this over and over and over again. And you're going to repeat this over and over and over again. And you're going to repeat this over and over and over again. So, bass drum ride, rack tom, floor tom, bass drum, snare and ride.
Randy Van Patten has a teaching style unlike any other.
Or you can go 1E and a 2E and a 3 triplet 4N with 2 eighth notes at the end. So let's experiment with a couple of those and see how it goes. All right, hey, okay. Okay, cut.